So let us consider addition of HCl over alkene. For example, we have this reaction. What will be the major product? Now, major product can be decided by Markovnikov rule. And this rule says hydrogen goes to the carbon which already has more number of hydrogen. For example, in this case, this carbon has only one hydrogen. This carbon has two hydrogen. So hydrogen will go to this carbon and chlorine will go to this carbon. So in this reaction, this is the major product. Now the question is, why not hydrogen go to this carbon? This means why not we get this product? So this product is not obtained, or you can say this product is a minor product. So we have to explain why this product is major and why this product is minor. Now this can be explained on the basis of mechanism. So let us first discuss mechanism of this reaction. So in the first step, a carbocation is generated. So if hydrogen goes to this carbon, we will have this carbocation. Now if hydrogen goes to this carbon, we will have this carbocation. This is a 2-degree carbocation. And this is 1-degree carbocation. So there are two possibilities. So let us call this is possibility 1 and this is possibility 2. Now we know 2-degree carbocation is more stable than 1-degree carbocation. So let us draw potential energy diagram. So initially we have alkene and H plus. So let us say this is possibility 1. In this case, 2 degree carbocation is formed. And the carbocation is a 2 degree carbocation. This is more stable. Now next we have possibility 2. In that case we have 1 degree carbocation. And that is less stable. So when 1 degree carbocation is formed, activation energy is higher compared to 2 degree carbocation. So in case of 1 degree carbocation, activation energy is high. So rate will be slow. Higher the activation energy, rate is slower. So this means chance of formation of 1 degree carbocation is less compared to chance of formation of 2 degree carbocation. So we can say in this reaction mainly 2 degree carbocation is formed. And in the next step, this carbocation is attacked by nucleophile Cl minus. And this gives the final product. So this is the basis for Markovnikov rule. So basically a stability of carbocation is directly related to Markovnikov rule. A stability of carbocation is directly related to Markovnikov rule. Let us try this problem. So we have this reaction. You have to write major product. With mechanism. So you have to also write mechanism. And clearly show the intermediate. And transition state. So let us try. In the first step, we will have nucleophilic attack by alkene on H plus. And we will generate a more stable carbocation. So this is the intermediate. Transition state will be this bond is breaking and carbon hydrogen bond that is forming. Hydrogen will have some positive charge and this carbon will have some positive charge. So this is the transition state. Now in the next step, the carbocation formed will be attacked by nucleophile, and nucleophile is Cl minus. So we will have this product. Now in this case we will have transition state. So carbon chlorine bond is forming and Cl will have less negative charge, and positive charge on this carbon gets neutralized. So this is second transition state. So let us call this is a transition state 1, then this is transition state 2. So basis for Markovnikov rule is lower activation energy for this transition state. So lower the energy of transition state, rate is faster. And that's why more stable carbocation is formed.